시계. I changed up. An online petition drive is demanding the removal of a local district judge for her treatment of an elderly cancer patient. I'm Greg Bowman.
Hey, we'll have that story for you coming up, but first let's update traffic and weather together at 11:18.
And this report sponsored by Amazing Smiles Dental Implant Center. Checking the AAA Jam Kims here. We have a crew causing delays along 94 westbound between Harper and Gratiot. That crew is making its way to 11 Mile Road where the right lane is blocked. Moving less than 40 miles per hour here. Time now for that National Electrical Contractors Association construction alert. The work continues north and south on 275 from Will Carlton to 8 Mile. Northbound I-75 from Outer Drive to Springwells. Work on the left shoulder here. Our crew is moving until about 2:30. Work continues. Maintenance work with the left lane closed. Eastbound 696 from Orchard Lake Road to Greenfield. Another moving work crew until 3 p.m. here, primarily on that right shoulder of 94 eastbound from 275 to Ecorse Road. A moving work crew on the Jeffries eastbound I-96 local lanes from Telegraph to I-75. That work here should wrap within the next 15 minutes. Imagine getting your smile back in one day, your confidence back in one day. Dr. Jindali at Amazing Smiles Dental Implant Center can do this for you. One location, the latest technology, and financing available. Don't hide your smile anymore. Take your life back by calling Amazing Smiles today, 248-955-9000 or amazingsmiles.us. Unix traffic update at 11:28 from the Tubby Sub Shops Traffic Center.
Thanks, Trish. You now the act with a forecast from the Bill Brown Ford Weather Center.
Blustering winds will finally start turning colder as temperatures fall back through the 30s into the 20s for the afternoon. Real feels end up in the teens. There could be some flurries tonight. Down to 13, real feels fall within a few degrees of zero. Tomorrow, sun and clouds, low to mid-20s, mostly sunny, low to mid-20s Friday. And we are going to stay dry in mid-20s for highs for Saturday and Sunday. I'm AccuWeather with the meteorologist, Steve DeVore, WWJ News Radio 950.
42 degrees and partly cloudy skies, maybe mostly cloudy skies in River Rouge. No, partly cloudy in River Rouge, 42. 40 degrees, partly cloudy in Chesterfield Township. 35 degrees and partly cloudy in White Lake Township. Right now at Detroit's Metro Airport, 42 degrees, fair skies. West wind at 16, humidity is at 55%.
It's January 2022, and I'm David Hall from Hall Financial. With mortgage interest rates likely to rise, you need to call Hall Financial right now. Now's the time to lower your monthly mortgage payment. Get started today at 866-CALL-HALL or chat with us online at callhallfirst.com.
WWJ News Time, 11:21, the update on sports at 11:23. A Macomb County woman accused of killing her husband, appearing in court yesterday and telling the judge it was self-defense. 34-year-old Shakina Thomas Alexander is accused of stabbing Gatorian Thomas Alexander on January 8th in their Warren home. Initially, she was charged with attempted murder, but her husband died 3 days later. She now faces a charge of first-degree murder. Prosecutors say this was not self-defense because the victim was stabbed in the back. The defense attorney says there is evidence of prior abuse. An online petition drive is demanding the removal of a district judge for her treatment of an elderly Hamtramck cancer patient who was fined for failing to maintain his lawn.
The Change.org petition is calling for District Judge Alexis Krott to be removed from office for what many are calling her cruel treatment of 72-year-old Burhan Chowdhury for having an overgrown lawn. Anjan Uden started the petition to remove Krott, claiming the judge has a history of being bigoted to immigrants.
The city that she's in, the majority of the population is they're immigrants. And for you to be biased against immigrants, like, it just doesn't make sense for someone to be in power but still, like, be biased against immigrants.
Uden says the petition has already gathered more than 200,000 online signatures. She's also started a Launch Good campaign to help the family pay for medical costs and other expenses. Greg Bowman, WWJ News Radio 950.
Sports coming up in about 60 seconds.
This is CBS Rewind. January 19th, 1980. Pink Floyd hit the top of the album chart with The Wall. It spawned three sequels and a TV series. And this thing in 1993, the Supreme Court refused to change the $2.5 million award that Tom Waits won when he sued Frito-Lay for using a
sound alike in a commercial.
I'm Brandon Brooks.